The Uganda Retirements Benefits Regulatory Authority was established in September 2011 following the enactment of the Uganda Retirements Benefits Regulatory Authority Act. Ever since its commencement, the authority has registered a number of significant strides, for instance, providing a leeway to savers in different schemes that use their accrued benefits for purposes of financing mortgages and housing loans.
In that summary, to launch the retirement benefits sector annual report for the year 2023, which I encourage many savers in the retirement benefit schemes to actually read and understand the performance of their funds, of the funds they are saving into these schemes.
In the 2023 annual performance report, which partially gives an insight on the sector's financial stand, the sector has registered an observable compliance improvement on remittance of contributions.
A prospective retiree should be interested in. Number two, how does the 2023 sector performance speak to the aspirations of the individual scheme member?
The biggest indicator of sector growth is the increase in total sector assets from 20 trillion shillings in 2022 to 22 trillion shillings in 2023, which growth is mostly a reflection of prudent investment of savers' funds with an average of 11% interest declared to members. Minister Lugolobi underscores the fact that this advancement is much significant to the country's economic development.
2023, the retirement benefits sector contributed 60% of gross domestic savings, accounting for 11.5% of the gross domestic product. So of all the savings, 60% are coming from the retirement sector.
Explaining the key factors behind the 2023 sector performance report, the Chief Executive Officer of Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority, Martin Anthony Nsubuga, cited the regulator's strict supervisory actions and increased compliance on the part of the regulated entities.
The sector was able to contribute to almost 12% of GDP in savings, and today it accounts for almost 60% of the total savings in the market. And I'm also proud to report that during the year, the sector was also to contribute around 235 billion in tax revenue in the coffers of government. All that we can say, we can continue to assure you of the protection of your money, to add value to you, to grow, and be able to address that old age poverty agenda which all aspire for.
Nevertheless, as the sector basks in the impressive performance of the retirement benefits, there is still a critical need on maintaining this positive trajectory with a major focus directed toward mass mobilization of the elderly in the informal sector on embracing the same.
Is this group of people, especially in the informal sector, which we are talking about, while all other sections are easy target because of the mandatory saving schemes like in NSSF, like public service pension schemes, where public servants would automatically enroll. As an authority, we find it a very big challenge given the fact that majority of Ugandans are in the informal sector.
The Uganda Retirement Benefits Regulatory Authority is responsible for regulating the establishment, management and operation of retirement benefit schemes in Uganda in both the private and public sectors. The authority is responsible for supervising institutions which provide retirement benefits, products and services. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.